Hi, I'm PGA professional J.R. Ross, Director of Instruction at the Dogwood Golf Academy. And today I'm here to talk to you about something that most of you probably don't have in your golf bag. And if you don't, you're probably missing one of the most vital pieces of equipment that you could use, the rule book. Often on the golf course, we encounter so many different situations that we're unsure of how to handle. As they say, common sense is not always so common. So today we're going to talk about a couple different rules, one being out of bounds and the other is a lost ball, and how we proceed when we get into these situations. So follow me out on the golf course. Let's go see what we do in these scenarios so you're not improperly playing golf. Here we are at the number one tee here at Dogwood, and we're going to talk about what happens if you hit your tee shot out of bounds. But before we do that, let's talk about how you identify out of bounds on a golf course. It can be identified with white paint. It can be identified with white stakes. It can be identified with a fence like we have here on the right-hand side of number one here at Dogwood. It can be identified by a road. Basically, out of bounds is defining the boundary of the golf course. So, if I hit my shot and I think it may be out of bounds, the one thing you always want to do is hit a provisional tee shot. The key word here is provisional. Provisional means I'm hitting a ball in case my first ball is out of bounds, okay? So once I've hit a provisional, if my tee shot actually is in bounds, that ball just goes in my pocket. If my provisional becomes a ball in play because my tee shot was out of bounds, now I'm hitting three. So anytime you hit your ball out of bounds and it is out of bounds, the penalty is stroke and distance. One stroke and you have to replay the ball from where you hit the ball from out of bounds. Now follow me and I'm gonna take you down here and show you the scenario on number one where the fence and the road meet, defining the out of bounds here on number one at Dogwood. As you can see, as I got up here, my golf ball is in bounds. So, no penalty shot, no provisional, maybe a little traffic to deal with out here. So the bigger challenge here may not be the golf shot. It may be staying safe and not getting hit by a car in this scenario. But back to the golf. As my ball is in play, I have to hit my shot. As you can see, the white line denotes the out of bounds here on number one. Good luck. I can hit the shot, no penalty. I'll go pick my provisional up in the fairway and we move on. Okay, so just remember, out of bounds means stroke and distance. I have to replay my shot from where I hit my original shot, take a penalty, hit my next shot. The other key word is provisional. Always announce if you're hitting that extra shot that you're hitting a provisional, because if you don't announce that, that in actuality becomes your shot, and now you are laying three, or you take your penalty shot and add on the provisional shot. So remember provisional, you pick the provisional up when you find your ball is in play and not out of bounds. Okay, so here I am, hit my tee shot here into the trees, look for my ball. My allotted time to look is 3 minutes. I get 3 minutes from the time I start my search. If I can't find it, I go back the same scenario as we just had without a bounds. The penalty again is stroke and distance. I have to hit my ball from where I hit the shot prior to being in here, adding a penalty shot. Again, 3 minutes is your search time. Provisional, again, to save you from having to go back. If you think you might hit your shot and may not find your golf ball, announce, I'm gonna hit a provisional in case I can't find my ball. This will do two things. One, it'll allow the pace of play to be quicker because you don't have to go back for what we call in golf the walk of shame, to walk back up to where you were and the people behind you notice, uh-oh, he hit one out of play, so he's walking back. You don't ever want to have to do that. Hit the provisional, can't find your original ball, your provisional becomes in play. Oh yes, and what a great feeling when you find your original ball and it's in play and you get to pick up your provisional. Once again, thanks for watching. J.R. Ross, PGA Golf Professional at the Dogwood Golf Academy. Again, tune in to YouTube, subscribe, hit the like button. Watch us every Wednesday and Friday for instruction and rules and etiquette needs.